Welcome back to Music Mondays.
Hello.
We are on episode
19?
Or 20.
I think it's 19.
Is it 19?
I'm pretty sure it's 19.
All right, should we start this again?
So, we have taken a little time off. Well, we haven't taken time off on our upload schedule, but we were on fall break. We were both out of town. So, it's been a little while. So, we don't really know what's going on. Just kidding.
Yeah, 19. We're 19. On
19. It's 19.
Nice. Nice team.
Should we have a 20th episode extravaganza?
Yeah.
Which is just going to be another episode.
It'll just be another regular episode. But maybe we'll go, woo!
Yeah, maybe we'll talk about how it's the 20th episode. Okay, so.
All right. Yeah. So this week, we've got the album Lush by Snail Mail. Snail Mail is a 19-year-old girl.
Oh, woman. She's 19?
Yeah. Her name is Lindsay Jordan. She's from Maryland. And she self-released her first EP, Sticky, in 2015.
If I was an EP, I'd be Sticky.
I am Sticky.
Yeah. Sorry to interrupt you. That thought just came to my mind, and then it came out of my mouth. Sorry.
No, it's okay. So in 2015, she would have been 16 years old when she self-released her
and
first
look where
EP.
We are.
Yeah,
in our early 20s
again. Yeah.
Tried our best.
Her second EP, Habit, she released with Sister Polygon Records in 2016. And Pitchfork actually added the opening track to that album, Thinning, to their Best New Track series, which is like a playlist that they have going. So that's pretty cool.
We like Pitchfork this week.
Yeah, we do. We really do. And she has 577,000 plus monthly listeners. So she's fairly small, but she got Pitchfork's attention.
I also have 577,000 monthly listeners.
Yeah, this podcast has like 9,100.
Like more like 9 trillion. That's like every person in the world
listens to this podcast.
Did you know that? I can't even leave my house anymore.
Do you think the demon in the White House listens to our podcast?
Probably. I hope not.
I hope not too. album, she actually released with Matador Records. It came out June 8th, 2018. Why can't I know numbers today?
I can't hear for a second, sorry. Keep going.
This album was fairly well received, and now she's touring for it. So
there she be, out on tour.
Yeah. But yeah, she's pretty neat. She does a lot of cool stuff by herself, and she's pretty independent for a 19-year-old.
Yeah.
Which is pretty neat.
I mean, she's out there doing big things, living her dreams, doing big things.
Yeah. Your favorite?
My favorite. So my favorite is Stick. I was telling Taylor, I was like, it's surprising I like the slow ones this week. She goes, you always like the slow ones.
Yeah.
And I was like, you're right. I'm a sucker for ballads, you know? I just feel a lot of emotion in that song. I mean, not that I don't feel emotion in the other songs, but like, that one just like, you know, just struck a chord for some reason.
I put it on my Sad Boy Hour playlist.
Yeah. Yeah.
And also, if you guys need a Sad Boy Hour playlist, I can tweet it out.
Taylor's got it. That's our Friday faves this week, is Sad Boy Hour. Yeah, it just, I mean, I think it's about kind of a breakup, right?
Probably.
Which, you know, another thing, I mean, I can't relate to that. We've talked about that. But it's just like, I don't know, it just, the feeling of the song itself just was like, you know?
It was heavy.
Yeah.
My favorite's Pristine. And the opening of it, like the opening chords, kind of sound like Foo Fighters' Everlong opening chords.
You're going to have to show me that when we're done, because I don't know it right off the top of my head.
Okay, I will.
But I believe you. The first time I heard Pristine, I was like, who's Christine? Then I read the title, and I was like, oh, moron.
And I even said that she's like the female love child of Nirvana and Foo Fighter.
Foo Fighter, singular.
Only one of the Foo Fighters.
The Foo Fighters are they fight the Foo.
Yeah.
I don't know where I was going with that. That's all I have to say. I'm done. I'll leave.
But I really dig it. I dig it.
Yeah, it's really good. It's good. It was one of those albums where, I mean, I'm not great at remembering song titles. Mm-hmm. That's not, you know, where I really excel in life. And she has that kind of thing where all the songs kind of like flow into each other, which I like, but that just makes it really hard for me to discern, you know, when I'm in the shower and I can't read the thing. Why are you frowning?
She started her classical guitar training at age 5.
Me too. I'm just kidding. I don't know how to play anything at all. My mom tried to get... She's like, Leah, I really think you should take piano lessons. And I was like, I don't want to. And I regret that decision every day.
You know...
Because now I don't know how.
I wanted to learn how to play an instrument so bad when I was little. Other than the flute.
Mm-hmm.
And my parents bought me... You know the guitar at Walmart that comes with a book? It's like a kid's guitar.
Like a little one?
Yeah. They got me that with the book, and they said, teach yourself out of this book, and then you'll get lessons. And I was like, hey, parents, this isn't how this works. I need lessons, and then I can work from a book.
Mm-hmm.
I can't read music yet. I'm 7.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can barely 7. Read in general.
Yeah.
And then I just... It was too difficult, so I never learned, and then that guitar sat in the corner of my room until I died.
I'm the kind of person, I'm very impatient, and, like, okay, when I say this, I'm not trying to say that, like, playing an instrument is easy, but when I watch someone do it, I'm like, that should be easy to do.
Yeah.
I can sit down and do that, which is just not at all the case, and then when I can't sit down and do it, I get pissed, and then I just stop.
Yeah.
I can play the mandolin, that's really random. I have one, and I can play it.
Maybe
I haven't played
that
in a while.
To be a part of the 20th episode.
Yeah, I can't do like the like ding ding ding. I can't do any of that, but I can like play chords and stuff. But that's it. That's all I know. I did play the saxophone in elementary school. In the Christmas like show, I did Jingle Bell Rock, which was pretty slapping. Mm-hmm. It was like it was terrible.
That sounds really good.
And I was the one person in the whole band that had... I had a silver saxophone because I was quirky.
Have I ever
silver
told you...
Silver saxophone, I love you. Okay, sorry.
Have you ever told me what?
About the kid in my high school that came into the lunchroom playing the saxophone.
It was me, probably.
So our school had, like, lunch periods. Like, there was, like, 3 lunch periods.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, A, B, and C, whatever. And during my lunch period, he had band.
Mm-hmm.
His name was Salvador. Great kid.
Of course it was.
He's very kind. I'm a big fan of Salvador. We heard a faint, like, saxophone noise coming closer to us down the hallway from the lunchroom. And, like, the loud roar from the lunchroom got...
Somebody just flushed the toilet.
It sounded like it was coming from my head. Though, so I was like, what's happening? But the, like, dull roar of the lunchroom, like, got quieter and quieter as he got closer and closer. He was playing the Sexy Sax Man song.
That's,
yeah, that one. And he comes through the lunchroom, and he, like, weaves through the tables. And then he comes back, and he got up on the table that I was sitting at. And, like, got really into it and, like, was leaning and, like, bending down on his knees. And all of the, like, teacher's aides were like,
huh?
What do we do? Like, what do we let this pass? Like, what's going on right now? And he got down and he just walked back down the hallway. He played the saxophone all the way back.
That's really something.
It was amazing.
Yeah.
And I'll never, like, that happened either freshman or sophomore year, and I don't think I'll ever forget it.
That's really beautiful.
Shout out to you, Salvador.
Hey,
he
Salvador.
Probably has no idea who I even am anymore.
Same. He doesn't. Well, hi, Salvador. You don't know me at all. That's really good. This is, we're not talking about this album at all. Sorry, people. We're just going to keep going like this.
I feel like when we just enjoy an album, we don't really have anything to say about it.
Yeah. We're a shit show.
Yeah.
The like George Michael song, they were playing that, the is that, I guess that's George Michael's. I don't really know. But in the variety show, there was a whole skit that was two band members playing that song and our chemistry teacher walking out on stage and being like, hey, quiet down. And then they screamed, she doesn't like George Michael's, and ran off. And that's it. It was a whole skit.
That sounds really good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Careless Whisper. Okay, so next week we're doing Careless Whisper.
Just that song.
So let's get back to what we like. Let's talk about this album that we're supposed to be talking about.
Talk about what you like.
Talk about what I like. Okay, so the other, I picked Stick as my favorite, and I also really like Deep Sea and Anytime. It has kind of that similar emotion. I typed Bangers Only Club. I don't know why I typed it, even though I typed it 10 whole minutes ago, and I already I don't know why that happened. Bangers with a Z, like the Miley Cyrus album, Bangers Only.
That just had its anniversary the other day.
Huh?
That just had its 5-year anniversary.
Happy birthday, Bangers. but she puts a lot into this album, and I really appreciate it. And it's she's doing that kind of singing. I don't want to be she's not singing, but she's kind of just I don't know how to describe it. Yes, it's singing, obviously, and it's good, but it's just that sounds gross when I do that, but I don't know how to how to describe it.
Yeah, she reminds me a lot of Courtney Barnett. Do you ever listen to her? She's Australian. I'll put you under her. You'd like her. But it's that same style.
Yeah. The way that I could describe it, I picked a bad way to describe it. I said she gives me kind of Willow vibes, and then you made that better if Willow was white and punk, which is exactly what I needed, because I'm yes, because she does the same kind of, it's always chesty when she sings. I guess that's a better way to describe it than,
It sounds like she's vomiting.
Yeah, she's puking, which is not at all what I meant, but it's fine. You understand me?
Yeah.
You understand?
We get it.
Get it?
Yeah.
I'm hot. I gotta take this off. I'm sorry. It's cold outside today, but it's one of those days where you're I don't know how to layer, because it's I told Taylor this earlier, I have the kind of clothes that's by themselves are too cold, but layered are too hot. So I don't. Anyway,
it's 46 degrees outside.
But I feel like it was colder yesterday. I felt colder yesterday, but it was also really windy and kind of gloomy.
Very windy yesterday. There's a chance of snow today, by the way.
All right. Well, here's the thing. See, we went straight to summer, and now we're snowing. It's fine.
It was 87 degrees on Saturday.
Yeah.
No, Sunday. And now it's 46.
Yeah.
How do we drop 40 degrees? Guys,
please recycle.
Just do anything.
Anything at all.
One day a week, eat entirely meatless. Recycle, reduce. Reduce is the number one word in reduce, reuse, recycle, because that's the most important.
Yeah.
Reduce your intake of things.
I'm not one of those vegetarians that's everybody should not be eating meat. But you shouldn't eat a lot, because it's, I saw a statistic, it was 1 pound of meat is equivalent, uses the same amount of water as 400,000 showers. So I'm not saying, I know that going vegetarian or going vegan is not an option for everybody. Just be conscious. That's the first step.
You don't
just be conscious. You don't have to cut anything out immediately. Just be conscious of what you're taking in.
And just watch Cowspiracy or something, because the impact that animal agriculture has on our environment is obscene.
Otherwise, we got 10 years left, kids. Read that climate report. Read it. Take it
in.
We're
rapidly escaping the ice age. We're in an ice age right now, and we're rapidly getting out of it, and humans can only exist in an ice age climate.
And if that doesn't scare the shit out of you, I don't know what will.
Welcome to Environment Mondays, because we're actually really serious about this.
And I just don't understand how people are oh, it's fine, this is a fear tactic. It's
no,
there
bitch.
Are physical signs that you are
stupid?
Experiencing that are showing you that that is not the case. not the case.
I'm just so mad about it.
I am mad too, and I take it really personally, which is not healthy, but
I mean, sure. I don't know. I'm just mad.
Yeah. I'm mad too.
I don't think any of my words are making sense at this point.
It's fine. We haven't talked about this album at all. I'm really sorry, but
snail mail. Snails are in the environment.
But
and they're mailing you
and
saying
our lives are more important.
Fucking dickhead about the environment. Thanks.
Our lives are more important than this album, no offense.
What if snails could send you mail and that's what it said? Quit being a fucking dickhead about the environment. If you got a piece of mail from a snail that said that.
Then I would accept death at that point, because that's all I need.
Do they write with their slime?
Yeah. And like, it takes them 9 years to spell it all out.
Climb. And then they jump as a space.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Quit.
And they spend their entire life doing so.
Just each snail writes each human a letter.
Yeah.
How many snails are there in the world?
Probably a lot. Anyway, if you want to keep living... Just, and it's not hard to, like, buy, or, like, good steps to take. Buy a reusable water bottle. Buy a pack of straws on Amazon that's, like, $5. And you can sit and argue and be like, it's all the big corporations. My changes won't do anything. And, like, yes, it is big corporations, and they are a major problem, and that needs to also change. But you can take steps to try to enact that, okay? Like, your carbon footprint does matter, because there's like 7 billion people, and if 7 billion people are like using 16 grocery bags every time they go shopping, that's a lot of waste. Mm-hmm. So like, reusable grocery bags, also another thing about reusable grocery bags, you can fit a lot of shit in them. Like a lot. I made a whole grocery haul and I used one bag.
So you know
all
those
my groceries in
big blue IKEA bags? Mm-hmm. Evan and Perfect. I used to do 2 weeks worth of grocery shopping for two people, and it would all fit in one of those bags.
Yeah.
And that bag is $1.99 at IKEA.
So I'm just saying, like, all you one trippers out there, sure fire way to always have one trip is to use reusable grocery bags. It's easy. Anyway,
just saying.
Let's talk about stuff from Pitchfork, I guess.
Yeah. So Pitchfork actually named this album Best New Music at its release, just like they did with Room 25.
Mm-hmm.
And they gave it an 8.7, which is awesome. And they said, with Lush, Jordan earns her place as a leader in the next generation of indie rock, the ones who are keeping the genre's honorable ideals alight while continuing to expand its purview beyond straight white dudes. Am I snapping?
Yeah. Do you not normally snap? No,
I usually can't.
I'm so happy for you!
I always do this and no sound comes out normally.
You gotta do it really hard, you know? Force. Oh, also, back on my environmental thing, that just reminded me, those reusable cups at Starbucks are $2 and you get 10 cents off every order with one.
Yeah.
Okay, back to Pitchfork. Yeah, I appreciate this album. It's, like, I'm not saying that, like, all indie music is moving towards a more poppy mainstream thing. When, like, I get that's what sells and I understand why it's happening. She pulls that back and is like, no, this is what it is. It's like raw indie music, which is like,
she sticks to her genre.
Paul was making fun of my hands last week because I went like this.
Listen to my podcast.
So
we should have a pasta podcast.
Uh-huh.
Like the the Rooster Teeth podcast has a pancake podcast once a year. We should have a pasta podcast.
20th extravaganza. We bring in noodles and we eat them.
Yeah.
While we record.
Yeah.
That's gross. But
that I'll would be like,
slurp.
Yeah.
Or we could just eat, we just like go to lunch before and then just talk about how we went to lunch.
Yeah. Sure. I still have those lots of coupons.
Anyway.
Anyways.
Yeah.
Yeah. I liked the entire Pitchfork article about it. They were very good. They really
said nice things.
Encompassed
yeah.
what she wanted to come out of the album? Are those words that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, like, I mean, that's what you hear, like, the whole, like, the indie ideals, like, all of the basic qualifiers for indie music are in there, and they're mm-hmm. obvious, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Big fan. I don't have anything that I don't like, I don't think.
I didn't either. I mean, like, This sounds bad. I guess, like, after, like, listening to the whole album, like, multiple times, because I was a little late getting to it, so I, like, blasted on a repeat. the style of singing gets a little abrasive when you're trying to just kind of chill.
Yeah, if you're...
Excuse me.
Goodness.
Is someone trying to break in?
Yeah, for real. And it's, but it, I mean, it's just like, that's because when I'm like doing work or like studying or relaxing, like all I can listen to is like Holocene by Bon Iver quietly. Like that's all, like, that's all I can handle when I'm like doing something that's not just listening to music. Yeah. But that's like, that's like a personal, like, what I can tolerate while I'm doing other things,
yeah,
kind of deal. And I guess that, which is really not something that I don't like, that's just something that I have to say. Because I was doing work yesterday and I tried to listen to it while I was doing that, and I was like, I can't focus on this.
It's also difficult to listen to if you're not trying to be sad. Because even if the lyrics aren't all sad, the tone of the music makes you sad.
Yeah.
And it's like, yo, I know I'm sad, like, most of the time, but I'm not trying to be like that right now.
Yeah.
I know I really do be like that sometimes, but right now it's not one of those times where I just...
You're like, I finally don't feel like a garbage can, so, like, give me just a minute.
Can you just, like, let me live my life without sadness for, like, 5 minutes?
Yeah. Okay, yesterday we were listening to Mamma Mia, and you know that Cher did a cover of Gimme Gimme Gimme?
She did an entire ABBA album.
I know. It's so good.
It is good.
I love it. Okay, anyway.
Easily favorite Twitter. Cher's Twitter is easily my favorite Twitter that exists.
Also, my Cher, Celine Dion, and Shakira impression all sound the same.
Yeah.
Because, and it's like, I know that they are very distinct, but they also, they have that kind of voice, and I don't know how to do it differently, so I just, it's all like this.
It's fine.
Wherever. Yeah, I also say wherever, because did we talk about this?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because I don't remember which one comes first, so I just say wherever twice, it's fine.
Whenever.
Because it's whenever, right? Whenever comes first.
You want to
eat. So then I say wherever first, and I'm like, oh, shit, and then I say wherever again, because that's right, and I'm just in the habit. Anyway, so what are we doing next week? Let's talk about that.
We are doing...
Hippocampus! They dropped a new album called Bambi, and it came out last Friday.
The Friday that we weren't here. Yeah, last Friday.
So, like, we know we're kind of late, but we had already pre-recorded an episode, so...
And, yeah, we pre-recorded an episode, and then
Florida,
we already had this one planned.
So, like, yeah. So, like, yes, technically we're a little bit late, but whatever, we're doing it. Bambi, here it is, it's Laps.
Also, guys, I have really big news. I have really, really, really big news. Are you ready?
Big news.
John Bellion finally announced when he's going to release his album.
I can't wait for that episode. You're going to die.
Week. November 9th, he's releasing that. So that's coming up. And then on November 16th, Anderson .Paak is releasing a new album. And I'm going to just...
Lose it.
Shit.
Just going to die.
I don't know. I'm hashtag blessed with a T. Because I just can't believe it. Also, Kurt Vile released some new music
also,
I just saw.
Here we are. But yeah, that's what we're doing next week. And also, like, if you ain't listening to Hippocampus yet, what you doing? Get behind it.
Yeah.
They're like, so here's like the trio of like the thing. They sound the same to me, but in a really good way. Like, so any of you, like Lainey, Coyne, and Hippocampus are like the trifecta of goodness. Can we slow this part down and do the Illuminati thing? Like, zoom in on my hands, making a triangle. Like, they're actually all the same people. And
the episode just ends.
But yeah, they're all really good. And I saw Coyne before I saw Walk the Moon, and I lost my mind. Anyway, that's not what we're talking about. So, you know what else you can listen to? You can listen to our Friday faves. And you know where you can find that? You can find it on our Facebook, on our Twitter, on our Instagram. And we talk about it here, so there it be.
And all you guys have to do is search my name on Spotify, too, and you can see all of my public playlists. So, like, my Sad Boy Hour, I have a Focus Beats playlist, which is, like, a good studying one. And then, obviously, the Music Mondays Friday faves.
Yeah. I mean, I guess you could look at mine, too. It's probably not as good, because I split it into, like, a couple genres, and then that's it. I do have a For Crying playlist, but I'm sure if you want, Taylor's For Crying or Taylor's Sad Boy is probably better, because all of my For Crying is just Bon Iver pretty much over and over again.
My Sad Boy Hour playlist is exactly an hour. Actually, it's an hour and 1 minute, so you get an extra 60 seconds of crying.
There you go. That's what, and that's usually what you need to just put your ride over the edge.
I also have like 75, 10 to 15 song playlists because I used to have a blog. Mm-hmm. So if you just need some music to listen to,
yeah, check out like listen to Friday Phase, but also she's got a lot of shit on there, so listen to it.
Shameless self plug.
Yeah. You can also, should we talk about Josie's podcast?
Yes. My best friend from home, Josie, and her boyfriend and a few of their friends just started a podcast, and they also want to make it like a vlog group kind of thing, and they're calling themselves Weird Media. It's WYRD, all caps. You can find them on Twitter, Instagram. And then they released their first podcast on Anchor, and you guys already know the deal with that. And it'll be on, they're hoping for it to be on Apple Podcasts and Spotify, either the Friday that we're recording this or by Sunday. Mm-hmm. So you guys can find it in a lot of places.
Yeah, if you find us, you can probably find them in the same place. So yeah. Do that. Also, I guess I'll plug Paul's again. Listen to Big Mood. It's great.
Yeah.
Talk about the youth of America. But yeah.
Yeah, theirs is just them babbling. Like at one point in the podcast, so we talked about... I think all of the podcasts are just babbling.
Yeah.
At one point in their podcast, Mylan asked, would you rather... Or do you think you could take on a bunch of third graders, I think, in waves of six? Like, do you think you could beat up six third graders in waves of six of them at a time?
No.
For, like, an hour.
No. I couldn't beat up anybody.
I feel like I'd just,
I could get my ass kicked by an infant baby.
Roundhouse them all. Or, like, scissor kick them all in the neck.
Yeah.
Probably be pretty satisfying to beat up a bunch of toddlers.
I would just run and probably still not be able to outrun them.
That's a really demonic thing I just said.
It's okay. I said that I could get my ass kicked by an infant baby. So, it's okay.
Anyways, check out other podcasts if you're bored with ours.
Listen to ours too, please. Thanks.
Thanks.
Yeah. So I guess that's it for this week. Come back next week for a little hippocampus, and maybe we'll be a little more focused. Probably not, but
maybe we'll yell at you about the environment some more.
That's what's important.
You probably deserve it.
Okay. So we'll see you next week on environmentally friendly Music Mondays.
Yes.
All right, kids.
I have a musical Monday.
I hate what I'm doing right now.
I just did the typical thing that you did in middle school.
Take your selfie from, up your neck.
Bye.